this bright pink sculpture, a sight to see at 400 South Logan Street, and part of the practice of the International Church of Cannabis, where members observe 42 seconds of silence and meditation.
Our congregation now views this sculpture as holy and sacred.
The city says it's outside of the church's property limit and is in the public's right of way without proper permits.
It is completely safe. It doesn't interfere with the public's right of way. You can walk around it. It doesn't block the sidewalk. So the city's argument that this is an encroachment is just not seeming like a valid one.
The irony in it all, co-founder Steve Burke says, is the structure's named Public Defender.
Represents the encroachment of the city upon the First Amendment. And so, you know, this for us is not just a religious liberty issue. It's also, you know, a constitutional issue.
In an email thread with Burke regarding the order of removal, the city says the church could submit an encroachment permit, but removal or submitting concept plans would be a better move because it will, quote, prevent wasting your time and fee payment awaiting initial response of permit review when it is already known as a non-permittable location.
Seems to me is the very definition of prejudice, right? They're prejudging our permit to be rejected before we've even applied.
The application deadline for the permit is tomorrow. The hopes is that the city will ultimately change its mind.
It just seems that it wasn't done in a very graceful way. And I want to be compliant. I want to be a positive asset to my community. And so, like, let's have some communication on how to do this the right way.
Now, Burke, who was just speaking there, says they did get one permit approved through the Public Arts Program and Administration. We also did reach out to Dottie and the city for further comment, and we have yet to get a response at this time. Live in studio, Gabby Easterwood, Fox 31.